Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me tell you about invisibles in Pages. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when you create documents in Pages, you're mostly typing characters, letters, numbers, symbols that you can see. But there are also invisible characters. So looking at this document in Pages, you can see that there are tons of invisible characters. What, you can't see them? Well, of course not. They're invisible. But there's a way to make them visible. That is to go to View and then Show Invisibles. And you can see the shortcut is Shift-Command-I. If we do that, it will reveal all the invisible characters. And here we can see the invisible characters as blue symbols. The most obvious one that you will see is, of course, the space. Spaces between words are characters, just like any letter or number. And usually they're completely invisible, but you can see them because they create a space between the characters around them. Now you can see them as a blue dot. Right away you can see how this is useful, because if I accidentally insert an extra space between two words, you can see that there are two dots. So this can help you find the situations where you've put too many spaces between words and easily get rid of them and make sure you just have one. So there are actually 9 invisible characters and a few other things that show up when you use View Show Invisibles. 3 of these are standard characters that appear in text, and 6 of them are what's known as breaks. So for the standard characters, the first one, of course, is the space. Another one is the tab, which you can see here, and it's simply generated whenever you use the tab key on the keyboard. So a lot of people may not use tabs at all, but if you've been typing for a long time, then you probably are just using tab out of habit from using a typewriter. If you use tab here, it tabs things over, and of course you can set custom tabs, but you can see the tab characters as a right-facing arrow and easily select them, delete them, and work with them thanks to Show Invisibles. The other character is what's called a non-breaking space. So for instance, say these two words belong together, like they're really one word, but usually there's a space in between them, but you don't want it to wrap from one line to the next. So instead of a space here, I can delete that space and see how easy that is using invisibles. I know exactly what I'm doing. And I can use Option Space, and that will insert a different looking space here. You can see a dot with a little hat on top of it. That's a non-breaking space. A non-breaking space means that this is considered one word and it won't wrap from line to line. Now the rest of the invisible characters are breaks. The most used break is a paragraph break, or sometimes called a line break. You could see it right here. That's actually a paragraph mark, the same mark that's been used for a long time for editors working with documents, way before computers. And this shows you wherever you hit return. So for instance, if I were to insert a new paragraph right here, I can easily delete this space. I don't have to leave it behind. If I hit return, you could see it places the paragraph symbol or paragraph break invisible character there. Another kind of break that you often see is a page break. We can see one down here at the end of page 2. Now at the end of page 2 you can see a lot of blank space. Sometimes people ask me, why is there a lot of blank space and how can I get rid of it at the end of this page, and why does the next page always start here? Well, it's probably because you inserted a page break. You do that using Insert Page Break. A page break looks like this. It gives you a long line and then a little page symbol there at the end. And it's actually a character between this period here and the first letter of the next paragraph. If I want to delete it, I can easily select it like that and delete it, and you can see now there's no character between the period and the M. And I can insert a return. If I want to have a page break here, I could just insert page break. Notice it leaves behind the paragraph break there. You can leave that there if you want. It won't really get in the way. Or you can easily use these invisible characters. Use the right arrow on the keyboard to go forward one, and you can see I'm between the paragraph break and the page break, and delete. And you can see it really looks the same if I turn off invisibles. Now in addition to a page break, there's also a section break. So let's say at the beginning of this paragraph here, I'm going to start a new section. I can use Insert Section Break. This acts very much like a page break, except that sections in Pages can have different properties. So when I go to document section, you could see things like the background and the page numbering and properties of headers and footers. They could be different on a section by section basis. So if I merely did a page break between these two pages here, then they would be part of the same section and have the same properties. But a section break allows me to have different properties between these two pages and all of the pages that are part of this section and all the pages that are part of this section. You can also have a column break. So I'm going to go and select all of the text, Command A, and then I'm going to go to Format, and then Text, Layout, and add a column. So now I have two columns here. Now suppose I wanted to do a page break, but instead of starting on the next page, I simply wanted it to start on the next column. I could go to the beginning of this paragraph right here and insert a column break. And you could see now it leaves the rest of this column empty. It gives me this invisible character here, this column break, and it starts on the next column. A page break would have made this start at the beginning of the next page instead. So another invisible character is called a line break. And this is very much like a paragraph break, except it won't actually break the paragraph. It just inserts a new line in the same paragraph. So for instance, I've got these two paragraphs here. And notice I have spacing set so that there is a 10-point break after each paragraph. Let's say I don't want to have that break here. I want this to all be one paragraph, but I do want a new line to start after this period. So what I could do is go here and delete the paragraph break and insert a line break. I could do that right here. I could also use Shift Return. And you can see instead of a paragraph break, I get this line break invisible character. And I can use it just like a paragraph break, except this is still considered one paragraph. So you won't see the spacing between paragraphs in between these two lines. In addition to that, if I were to change the style for the paragraph with the cursor at the first part of it, it will change it for the entire paragraph. So this is considered one paragraph for styles and for spacing as well. And there's one more break that you can use. See, when you use columns, you don't have to change the columns for everything. You can select one or more paragraphs, go to Format, Layout, and make this two columns. And you can see this paragraph has one column, this paragraph has one column, but this paragraph is actually two columns. And here you could see an invisible character appear right there between this paragraph and this paragraph. It replaces the paragraph break and it's called a layout break. And this only comes up in this situation here where you're going from different numbers of columns within the same document. Now when you use View Show Invisibles, there are two other things that can show up. One is any kind of link. So if we were to select some text and then go to Format, Add Link, and add any kind of link here, like let's just add a web page link. With Show Invisibles on, you could see that the link is now in a blue box. So that's completely invisible normally. Now normally a link would have an underline on it, but in this case, under Format, Text, Style, I have changed the character style for a link to not include any underline. So you can see how it's completely invisible now that this is a link or a bookmark or anything like that. So I can use Show Invisibles to see where those links or bookmarks are located. And the other thing is whenever you insert an image or a shape or anything like that and you use a special kind of format arrange here. If you use Stay on Page, then this is just a page element and it's not linked to the text at all. And if you use Move with Text and then inline with text, it's actually just like a character in between, you know, this character and this space right here. But if you use move with text in anything else, like automatic, then when you select this, you'll see the anchor point for this. It's this little lollipop looking symbol. And you'll actually see that even if you have invisibles turned off. As long as the item is selected, you'll see this anchor point. So this isn't really a character in between, say, the T and the space between the T and the C here. This is just a point here, and it could change depending upon where you move this. So if I move it down here, you can see now that's the anchor point. And if you want to figure out what page this will appear on, well, the anchor point will tell you that. So let's move this all the way down here towards the bottom, and you could see the anchor point's right there. If I were to add some extra lines and then continue down, as soon as that line with the anchor point is on the next page, you can see this item here moves. So the anchor point determines where an object set to a range, move with the text, and any kind of wrapping except inline will appear. So the main point of Show Invisibles is to make it easier for you to edit your document with precision. You can see where each space is, where there may be extra spaces. You can see if something is a paragraph break, a page break, or a section break. And you can select those characters either using your pointer and your mouse or trackpad or using the arrow keys to get right after the character, hit delete to delete it, or go before it to insert something just before that special character. You can also, of course, use the arrow keys with shift to select something. So I can go right up to this paragraph symbol here, hold shift down and right arrow, and you can see now I've selected that paragraph mark. If I go over here and I use shift, right arrow, you can see I've selected that tab. So you can really act with precision within your Pages document and turn their visibility on or off as you need. The characters are always there, but you can turn on or off the special blue symbols that show you where they are as you need using either View and Show or Hide Invisibles or Shift, Command, and I. If you like this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.